Hi children, how are you? Today we are going to start with a new block, block number 7, orchestra practice, okay? But before, I am going to pray, okay? Please pay attention. Okay, let's continue. Okay, Saint Dominic, spirit of truth, sincerity, humility, modesty, silence, recollection, love for souls, come to us. Amen. Okay, let's continue. I am going to present the new words for you. The first word is tambourine. Muy bien, tenemos la pandereta. Observe the picture. You have the meaning in English here. Observe. Okay, students. Aquí claramente dice metal disc. Fíjate, son discos de metal. Okay. Aquí hay una palabrita también que dice guden, es una parte también que está hecha de madera, ¿ok? Let's continue. The next is triangle. Triangle is very easy for you. Observe the picture, please, ¿ok? Aquí dice thin metal bar, es una barra delgadita de metal, ¿no es cierto? La cual vamos a golpear y vamos a emitir, ¿no es cierto?, un sonido, ¿ok? The next is trumpet. Observe the picture, is trompeta, ¿ok? Dice que termina con una parte estrecha en la parte del final, ¿ok? Ok, let's continue. Trombone. Fíjate aquí, observe the picture, please. Observe here, you have the meaning in English. U shaped piece, dice, ¿no? Es una pieza con una forma en U, tiene una forma de U. Obsérvale bien, ¿sí? ¿Ok? The next is drums. Okay, observe the picture. Okay, drums is very easy for you. The next, harp. Observe harp. A harp is a large string musical instrument. Okay, es un instrumento musical de cuerda. Observe, please. Okay, let's continue. Saxophone. Okay, observe the picture. Es el famoso saxofón. Aquí dice blowing, ¿cierto? Vas a soplar y obviamente emites el sonido, ¿ok? Let's continue. We have keyboard. Observe, keyboard es el teclado, ¿cierto? ¿Ok? Let's continue. Violin. ¿Ok? Violin, igual. Aquí dice strange instrument. Es un instrumento de... Perfecto, es un instrumento de cuerda, ¿ok? Let's continue. Guitar, observe guitar. A guitar is a musical instrument with a long neck and strings. Long neck and strings, ¿ok, students? Let's continue. In this moment, I am going to present the student book. Observe, please. We have orchestra practice. I have 9 words. Tú me dirás, teacher, pero en la primera presentación usted nos mostró 10. Y la última era guitar, ¿cierto? Vimos que era conveniente aumentar una palabra más. Es por eso que viste en la primera presentación 10 palabras, ¿ok? In this moment, we are going to practice the correct pronunciation of the words again. Please pay attention. Tambourine.
2. Triangle.
Triangle.
3. Trumpet.
Trumpet.
4. Trombone.
Trombone.
5. Drums.
Drums. Harp.
7. Saxophone.
saxophone.
8. Keyboard.
Keyboard.
9. Violin.
Violin. Okay, students. Now, let's continue with the next part. Listen and correct the sentences. You have 4 sentences here. You are going to listen the story, and then we are going to correct the sentences. Please pay attention. Listen carefully. Please listen.
Student's book, page 82. 2. Listen and correct the sentences. Maybe the next line's here, at our orchestra practice. And we're the first ones here, so let's have a look around.
Good idea. The map shows a harp. And I can't think of any other musical places in town. Do you think it's on one of the instruments, maybe?
I don't really know. Let's check.
Let me see. It isn't on the violin, or the trumpet, or the triangle.
And it isn't on the keyboard, or the drums either.
Stop looking now.
Okay, we can look for the line again on the break.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay, students, now I am going to present the answers for you. So, let me see. Okay, you have here a student's book, page 82. Listen and correct the sentences. Okay, students? Remember, the first sentence is, Lucy and Ben arrived last. The first sentence is, Lucy and Ben arrived first. Okay, the sentence 2, Ben knows other musical places. The correct sentence is, Ben can't think of any other musical places. Okay? The sentence number 3, they check 6 instruments. Number 3, the correct sentence, they check 5 instruments. Number 4, the sentence is, they can look again at lunchtime. But the correct sentence is, they can look again in the break. Okay? So, students, let's continue. Chicos, en la parte de las respuestas que te acabo de presentar, es solamente para que practiquemos. Como estamos en semana de evaluaciones, pues no te mando a que hagas nada en el cuaderno. ¿De acuerdo, chicos? Entonces, vas a esperar que te mande las instrucciones. Sin embargo, así adelantamos un poquito, ¿ya? Ok, let's continue with the workbook in this moment. Okay, workbook, orchestra practice, the first page. Okay, students. You have the first activity, listen and circle. Chicos, esto sí lo va a poder ir completando, ¿de acuerdo? Okay, listen please and circle the correct option. Okay, please pay attention.
Circle. 1. 2.
Okay, students. Now let's check. The correct answer in number two is perfect, is trumpet. Number three, drums, keyboard. The correct answer is drums. In number four, the correct answer is keyboard. In number five, the correct answer is saxophone. Number six, the correct answer is harp. In number seven, the correct answer is triangle. In number eight, the correct answer is trombone. And number nine, the correct answer is tambourine. Okay, students, now you have the last activity. Find the triangles and write sentences. Fíjate que en cada lugar de aquí, tú tienes el triángulo. La idea es buscar en dónde están los triángulos, ¿ok? Pero aparte de eso, vamos a formar una oración. You have an example here. There's a triangle under the tambourine, ¿ok? There's a triangle under the tambourine. Ok, in this part, ¿ok? I am going to present. Ok. Okay, workbook page 82, find the triangles and write sentences. Observe, there is a triangle between the violins, ¿cierto? Fíjate bien, aquí vas a encontrarlo. Entre los violines hay otro triángulo. Number two, there is a triangle on the drum. ¿Encima de dónde? Perfecto, encima del tambor. Number three, there's a triangle behind the harp. ¿Dónde está el triángulo? Perfecto, está detrás del arpa. Number four, there's a triangle on the keyboard. Muy bien, hay otro triángulo encima del teclado. Number five, there's a triangle behind the recorder. Hay un triángulo detrás de ¿dónde? Detrás de la flauta, ¿ok? Tú le puedes ir chequeando la posición en tu workbook de cada uno, ¿cierto? Y le vas añadiendo en la página 82, page 82. Ok, students, con eso habremos avanzado un poquito. Y la siguiente semana, sí, como vamos a tener clases virtuales, entonces ahí seguimos practicando y continuamos. ¿De acuerdo, chicos? Goodbye. See you the next. Bye-bye.